Good afternoon, everyone. In the last video, we have the questions related to the 15th group, nitrogen family. We have discussed there almost 60 questions. And in this video, we will see the remaining questions related to the 15th group. In that, the first question, H3PO3 on heating gives X and Y, where Y is a gas. Then choose the correct option. They have given four options here. First of all, H3PO3, if we heat it, it can undergo disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation means it will give phosphoric acid and phosphine. Where phosphine is a gas, so Y should be the phosphine. Why? Because they mentioned that where Y is the gas and phosphine is a gas here. And Y has a smell of ammonia. Phosphine is not a smell of ammonia. It is a rotten fishy smell. Basicity of X is 2. So here phosphoric acid should be X, but its basicity is 3. So this is also not correct. X and Y are non-planar. Yes, both are non-planar in nature. This is correct. We check option D. Y is sp3 hybridized. And we know that the 15th group hydrides, only ammonia can undergo hybridization. And there is no hybridization of remaining hydride, phosphine, arsine, antimony, bismuthine. There is no hybridization involvement. That is according to the Drago's rules. And this is also not correct. So here option is C for 61 question. Next question. Which of the following on hydrolysis will give dibasic acid? PCl5, if you hydrolyze it, we will get phosphoric acid, and whose basicity is 3. PCl3, if we hydrolyze it, we will get H3PO3, and whose basicity is 2. So hence this is a dibasic acid. Similarly, BCl3, if we hydrolyze it, it is a monobasic, and silicon tetrachloride, if we hydrolyze it, we will get tetrabasic acids. So option B. Next, 63. Nitrogen can be prepared by, we can prepare nitrogen by decomposition of sodium azide. Sodium azide NaN3. If we decompose it, we will get pure form of nitrogen here. With the decomposition of ammonium dichromate also can give. This part we discussed, I think, already. And here also we will get nitrogen. And ammonium nitrite also can give. Ammonium nitrite means NH4NO2, and this also on thermal decomposition can produce nitrogen. And so all of these compounds can give nitrogen on thermal decomposition. Which metal will give nitrous oxide by cold and dilute HNO3? Nitrous oxide means N2O. So N2O can be produced by zinc. Zinc, if you treat with cold and dilute nitric acid, will get nitrous oxide. Next. The very purest form of nitrogen is prepared by thermal decomposition of barium azide. Sodium azide and barium azide can give the purest form of nitrogen. Which of the following will give hydrogen gas with dilute HNO3? Zinc can give, just now we have discussed, it will give the nitrous oxide, and copper, mercury, they can give the nitric oxides. But magnesium can produce. Magnesium is a highly electropositive metal. When reacts with dilute acids, they can liberate hydrogen. And option A here. Next. Choose the correct statement regarding allotropes of phosphorus. We have three allotropes: white phosphorus, red phosphorus, and black phosphorus. White phosphorus exists as a discrete P4 molecules. Yes, this is correct. Order of reactivity. White phosphorus is more reactive due to the high angle strain than after red phosphorus and black phosphorus. This is also correct. And black phosphorus is a conductor of electricity because it exists in the form of hexagonal layers like graphite. This is also correct. Black phosphorus is a good conductor and more stable in nature. So answer, all given statements are correct here. Ammonia can be dried by. So to remove the moisture from ammonia, we have to use a dehydrating agents, but the best dehydrating agent we can choose here, calcium oxide quicklime. And where is the calcium chloride, sulfuric acid and phosphorus pentoxide we cannot use here. Why? Because they can react with ammonia. In cyclotrimetaphosphoric acid molecules, how many single and double bonds are present? First you have to check this cyclotrimetaphosphoric acid. The formula is HPO3 taken thrice. The structure of this compound is like this. In each phosphorus, it can form bond with the OH. This is a structure of cyclotrimetaphosphoric acid. Here we have to count the total single and double bonds. A single bond. Each phosphorus can form 4 bonds with 4 oxygen atoms and 1 oxygen hydrogen bond. 5. So like that we have 3 phosphorus sources are there. 3 into 5, 15 single bonds. And each phosphorus can form double bond with oxygen. So 3 double bonds. So total we have 3 double bonds and 15 single bonds. So it should be the option 1. Next. On heating with concentrated NaOH solution in an atmosphere of carbon dioxide, white phosphorus gives a gas. Which of the following statement is incorrect about that gas? So heating with concentrated NaOH, white phosphorus. This is a chemical reaction. White phosphorus, when you treat with NaOH, it will give one gas. That is the gas is phosphine gas. Apart from that, we will get sodium hypophosphite. And this gas, properties of this gas, we have to check here. It is highly poisonous and has a smell like rotten fish. Yes, this is correct. Its solution in water decomposes in presence of light. Yes, this is correct. It is more basic than ammonia. Generally, 15th group hydrates basic nature top to bottom decreases. Means it is less basic than ammonia, not more. This is correct. But this statement is incorrect. That is why option C is the incorrect option here. Next. The oxidation state of central atom in the anion compound NaH2PO2 will be. Anion means here H2PO2 minus is anion. And Na plus is a cation. The central atom phosphorus. And here phosphorus oxidation state is plus 1. So it should be option C, plus 1 oxidation state. In solid state PCl5 is, generally in solid state PCl5 exists as in ionic form like PCl4 plus and PCl6 minus. PCl4 is a tetrahedral, PCl6 minus is octahedral. This is option D. The correct order of oxidation states of nitrogen in NO, N2O, NO2 and N2O3 is. As we know that the acidic nature, oxidation states. Oxidation state we can calculate here. This nitrogen plus 2, your nitrogen plus 1, your nitrogen plus 4 and this nitrogen plus 3. So we have correct order. They are given here increasing order. So which is having more? NO2 is having more. So NO2 next N2O3 NO N2. And here option B is correct. The pair that contains 2 pH bonds in each of the oxo acids is. We have given H4P2O5, H4P2O6. You can see H4P2O5 structure. This is the structure of H4P2O5, pyrophosphorus acid, this one. Next, you can take H3PO2. H3PO2 structure is this one. So here it contains the pair that contains two pH bonds. And here H4P2O5, it has a two pH bonds, and similarly H3PO2 also it has a two pH bonds. So it should be option D. The order of oxidation state of the phosphorus atoms in phosphorus, hypophosphorus, phosphorus, phosphoric, and this hypophosphoric. Here H3PO2 oxidation state is +1. H3PO4 oxidation state +5, H3PO3 oxidation state +3, and whereas H4P2O6, the structure is like this. So here each phosphorus, it carries +4 oxidation state. So average +4, and this is +4 oxidation state, which is having more your phosphoric acid. And then after this hypophosphoric acid, phosphorus, and option B is the correct. Species in which nitrogen atoms in its state of sp hybridization is, in NO2-, the hybridization is sp2 hybridization, in NO3-, the hybridization is sp3 hybridization, and this also sp2 hybridization, and NO2+ is sp hybridization. Next, the pair in which phosphorus atoms have a formal oxidation state of +3, pyrophosphorus acid. Just now we have checked that pyrophosphorus acid is H4P2O5. Here the phosphorus oxidation state is +3. Next, hypophosphoric acid. Hypophosphoric acid oxidation state is +4. Just now we have discussed H4P2O6. Oxidation state is +4. That is not correct. Orthophosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid +3 oxidation state, and hypophosphoric acid +4 oxidation state. Pyrophosphorus acid +3 and pyrophosphoric acid +5. Orthophosphorus and pyrophosphorus. In this case, both are having +3 oxidation state. Orthophosphorus means H3PO2. Here the oxidation state +3. And pyrophosphorus acid, and this is the one, and here also oxidation state +3. Both are having +3 oxidation states. Next, which of the following properties is not shown by NO? Nitric oxide. It is paramagnetic in liquid state, and this is paramagnetic in gaseous state, but in liquid state it undergo dimerization and is a diamagnetic. This is not, it is a paramagnetic in, this is not correct. It is a neutral oxide, yes, this is correct. It combines with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide is correct. It's a bond order. NO, we have 15 electrons. So according to molecular order theory, 15 electron means bond order is 2.5. So these three are correct and this is incorrect. So it will not show this property. Only in gaseous state it is paramagnetic, not in liquid state. Which ordering of compounds is according to the decreasing order of the oxidation state of nitrogen? Again, you can check the oxidation states of nitrogen here. HNO3 +5, NO +2, ammonium chloride, nitrogen -3, and nitrogen 0. One is a 0, -3, +2, +5. So, -3 is the minimum value, and this is a -3 minimum. Next, 0 and +2 and this is plus 5. This is arranged in a proper decreasing order. This is a correct order. Option B. The percentage of P character in the orbitals forming PP bonds in P4. In P4, the hybridization of phosphorus is sp3. In case of sp3, the P character should be 75%. S character is 25 and P character is 75%. A pale blue liquid obtained by equimolar mixture of two gases. A pale blue liquid means this is a nitrogen trioxide, N2O3. It has a pale blue liquid. For H3PO3 and H3PO4, the correct choice is, according to their structures, H3PO3 dibasic and reducing, and this is correct. With respect to both, we have to check. H3PO3 is dibasic but non-reducing. This is not correct. H3PO4 is tribasic and reducing. This is not correct. H3PO3 is tribasic and non-reducing. So only first one is correct. H3PO3 non-reducing is incorrect. H3PO4 tribasic but it is non-reducing. Then this is also not correct. Among the trihalides of nitrogen, which one is least basic? For trihalides of nitrogen, from fluorides to iodides, the basic nature increases. This is a basicity order. NF3 is the least less Lewis basic in nature than NCl3. Then after NBr3 and Ni3. Why? Because your fluorine is a more electronegative in nature, it can pulls the lone pair electron on the nitrogen atom. That is why we have the less tendency to donate lone pair on this nitrogen. But here, iodine, due to the less electronegative in nature, it cannot pull the electrons. The nitrogen can donate these lone pair very easily. Hence, it can access a good Lewis base compared to the remaining trihalides. So here the option should be D option. Ni3 is the they are asking least basic. Least basic means NF3 and more basic means Ni3. So this is the least basic. So option should be NF3. So which one of the following oxides of nitrogen is a colored gas? Generally NO and NO2, they are paramagnetic, but NO2 is a brown colored gas. This is correct. It is NO is a colorless. The bonds present in N2O5, the structure of N2O5. And this is the N2O5 structure. Here we have both covalent and this is a coordinate bond. Coordinate bond and covalent bond. So option B. So these are some single correct choice questions. Now we will see some more integer type questions. The total number of compounds having at least one bridging oxo group in at least one of the resonance structure among the molecules given below. N2O3, they are asking oxo group, bridging oxo group means we should have the structure like some element or metal, oxygen, metal or element, oxygen, element bond should be present. In case of N2O3, yes, we have the structure, one of the resonance structure is like this. So it has N2O5 also, just now we have discussed that it has the nitrogen, oxygen, nitrogen bond. P4O6, phosphorus oxide, they are having phosphorus, oxygen, phosphorus bonds. This also we checked already. P4O6 and P4O7 both are same, almost. In case of P4O7, just you write similar to the P4O6 structure. Mm. into. This is a P4O6. We have phosphorus, oxygen, phosphorus. Oxo linkage is there. P4O7 means one extra oxygen. So one of the phosphorus can take the double bond. Anyhow, this is a P4O6. This skeleton is constant. It has 6 POP linkages. It also having the that one. H4P2O5. This is a pyrophosphorous acid. Just now we discussed that in case of pyrophosphorous acid, we have the POP linkage again. This is also correct. H4P2O6. Here there is no POP linkage. We have directly PP linkage. This structure also just now we did it. Here no POP linkage. H5P3O10. This is a tripolyphosphoric acid. The structure of that H5P3O10 is like this. It also having two POP linkages. And this is the structure of H5P3O10. Again, we have POP linkage. And this is also having. So, out of these 7 compounds, 6 are having this H4P2O6. It doesn't having that oxo group. So, total 6. The answer is 6 here. Next. Atomicity of white phosphorus is X. White phosphorus means P4 and whose atomicity is X, and X equal to 4. Then total number of lone pairs and PP bonds in white phosphorus are Y and Z respectively. They are asking find the value of X plus Z minus Y. Total number of lone pairs in white phosphorus, the structure of white phosphorus. So discrete tetrahedral units, the PP bond, and each phosphorus carries one lone pair. So we have total 4 phosphorus atoms are there. So total number of lone pairs should be 4, and PP bonds, total number of PP bonds, that is Z. How many PP bonds are there? There are the 6 PP bonds. Now the question is X plus Z minus Y. X plus Z means 4 plus 6 and minus 4. Again it equal to 6. Next question. Consider the thermal decomposition of given below. The lead nitrate and thermal decomposition can give compound A, it is a solid, and B is a gas and C is a gas. When gas B is allowed to cool down below minus 11 degrees Celsius, then it is solidified and exists as ion pair. What is bond order of the cation? First of all, when you heat this lead nitrate, we'll get lead monoxide and gas B will get nitrogen dioxide. And gas C is the oxygen gas. This is the thermal decomposition reaction of lead nitrate. Now gas B, this is NO2. NO2 is allowed to cool down. So NO2 can undergo dimerization on cooling. It will give N2O4, the dimer form of nitrogen dioxide. And this N2O4 exists as the ionic pair form like NO plus and NO3 minus. This is the existence of self-ionization of N2O4. And they are asking, what is the bond order of cation? So what is the cation here? NO plus is a cation. And NO plus bond order is 3. Why? Because the total number of electrons in NO plus is 14 electrons. 14 electrons nothing but the bond order is 3 according to molecular orbital theory. Next. Nitric acid on treatment with the dehydrating agent P4O10, we are getting N2O5 and this metaphosphoric acid, tetramer of metaphosphoric acid. Find out the value of expression mod X minus Y for every reaction. And here X indicates maximum number of equal NO bond lengths in N2O5. And Y is difference of oxylinkages EOP between P4O10 and HPO3-4. Now here, first of all X. What is the X here? Maximum number of equal NO bond lengths, N2O5. Again, N2O5 structure. Just now we have seen that. We can write N2O5 structure like this also. Instead of double bond, that coordinate bond. This is a normal skeleton structure. Here, these terminal oxygen bonds are equal than the bridge. Bridged oxygen bond length is different. But all four terminal oxygens, they are having identical nature. So, we have maximum number of equal NO bonds. How many they are? Four. Next, Y. What is the Y? Difference of oxy linkages. Which POP linkages between P4O10. Just now we have discussed that phosphorus oxide. We have total 6 POP linkages. And HPO3-4. This is a tetrametaphosphoric acid. Just now we have did the draw the structure of tricyclometaphosphoric acid. In case of tetracyclometaphosphoric acid, we have take one more extra POP linkage. And this is the structure of tetracyclic metaphosphoric acid, and the structure is like this. Here we have 4 POP linkages. So 6 minus 4. They are asking how many POP. And that should be equal to 2. Now overall we have to calculate the expression value for X minus Y. What is the X here? 4 and Y is 2. Now X minus Y is equals to 4 minus 2. That is equals to 2. And this is the answer. Next, let us consider the following reaction. Sodium hydroxide, if you treat with N2O5, we are getting X and Y, where X is a sodium salt. What is the difference in the oxidation states of nitrogen in X and Y? And for this solution, sodium hydroxide, when you treat with N2O5, N2O5 is a strong acidic oxide, it's a kind of acid-base reaction, you will get a salt, sodium nitrate salt and water. You get H2. In here, this X is a sodium salt, so NaNO3 is the X and Y should be the water. What is the difference in the oxidation state of nitrogen X and Y? In X, nitrogen oxidation state is +5. In Y, there is no nitrogen, so 0. So difference should be 5 minus 0, it should be 5. If basicity of H3PO2, H3PO3 and H3PO4 are X, Y and Z respectively, then find X plus Y plus Z. H3PO2 basicity 1, H3PO3 basicity 2 and basicity for H3PO4 is 3. And if we add together, we will get 6. Find the number of compounds which liberates nitrogen dioxide gas as one of the products on heating. There are ammonium nitrate, magnesium nitrate, sodium nitrate, ammonium nitrite, mercury nitrate, silver nitrate, lithium, potassium and lead nitrates. Here ammonium nitrate, it can produce nitrous oxide, so no nitrogen dioxide here. Magnesium nitrate, yes, it can give the nitrogen dioxide. Sodium nitrite, they can produce nitrites and oxygen. In the last video, we have discussed this. Again, there is no generation of NO2. Ammonium nitrite, it will give the nitrogen. So nitrogen and water, so no NO2 here also. Mercuric nitrate, it can give mercuric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Silver nitrate also can give. Lithium nitrate also can. Lithium nitrate is similar to the magnesium nitrate, diagonal relationship. A potassium nitrate, sodium, again they are similar. Again here no generation of that. Lead nitrate, again it can give. So how many are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, total 5 nitrates. They can liberate nitrogen gas on thermal decomposition or are simply heating. H90. Number of POP bonds in cyclic trimethylphosphoric acid is X. And number of PP bonds in pyrophosphorus acid is Y. Then X minus Y. So this just now we have discussed that cyclic trimethylphosphoric acid, the number of POP linkages are 3. Here X equal to 3. And number of PP bonds in pyrophosphorus acid. This also just now we checked that we have 1 PP bond in pyrophosphorus acid. Sorry, pyrophosphorus acid, 1 POP, PP bond, no PP bond. Pyrophosphorus acid. This is a pyrophosphorus acid. Right here they are asking PP, not POP. POP from cyclic trimethylphosphoric acid and PP from pyrophosphorus acid. So X equal to 3 and Y equal to 0. Then X minus Y equal to. So your answer should be 3. Next. Ammonia is formed. Ammonia is formed due to hydrolysis of Z, which is similar to graphite structurally. And Z is empirically similar to Xn. What is the difference between atomic numbers of elements in Z? So ammonia can be formed hydrolysis of Z, which is similar to graphite structurally means that should be boron nitride. Boron nitride, it is structurally similar to the graphite, and this on hydrolysis can give ammonia. It will produce ammonia. And here boron nitride should be Z. And this is empirically similar to the Xn, and Z is Xn. Means what? Where X should be the boron atom and N should be the nitrogen atom. And what is the difference between atomic numbers of elements in Z? So in Z we have boron and nitrogen and their atomic numbers. Boron atomic number 5, nitrogen atomic number 7. The difference between 7 and 5, it is 2. The answer should be the 2 here. Boron nitride, so the elements atomic number difference. Next. The number of NN bonds in N2O5 is X and number of PP bonds in H4T2O6 is Y. Then find X plus Y. A number of nitrogen-nitrogen bonds in N2O5. Just now we have checked that there is no NN bonds. So X equal to 0 here, and number of PP bonds in H4P2O6 here we have. This structure also just now we have drawn that. So here Y equal to 1 and X equal to 0, then X plus Y equal to overall 1. Next. PCl3 and hydrolysis can give compound X plus HCl. X is an azo acid of phosphorus, which on strong heating at 200 degrees Celsius gives Y and Z. Then sum of oxidation numbers of phosphorus in Y and Z is. And what is X? PCl3 on hydrolysis will get phosphorus acid H3PO3. And this H3PO3 on strong heating, it can undergo this disproportionation reaction. On disproportionation, it will give 1 phosphoric acid and phosphine. So where Y should be the phosphoric acid and Z should be the phosphine. Y and Z in the sum of oxidation numbers of phosphorus. In case of phosphoric acid, the oxidation state is plus 5. In phosphine, the phosphorus oxidation state minus 3. So sum means plus 5 minus 3, you will get 2. Next. When zinc reacts with concentrated nitric acid and dilute nitric acid, produces oxides of nitrogen P and Q respectively. What is the sum of oxidation states of nitrogen in P and Q? If zinc reacts with concentrated nitric acid, we will get nitrogen dioxide. So here P should be the nitrogen dioxide, and with the nitric acid it will give nitrous oxide. Dilute HNO3 can produce nitrous oxide. So here Q should be the nitrous oxide. Now what is the sum of oxidation states of nitrogen P and Q? Here oxidation state plus 4 and Q here oxidation state plus 1. Thus overall sum plus 1 plus 4, it is 5. So here the answer is 5. The number of oxides of nitrogen which produce HNO3 when dissolved in water. N2O in dissolution it can give hyponitrous acid, H2N2O2. NO, it can is a mixed anhydride type, it will not give HNO3. NO2 again, this is a mixed anhydride, it can give HNO3. And HNO2 is a mixed anhydride. N2O4, both NO2 and N2O4 both are same only. They are, one is a monomer, one is a dimer form. So both can give same type of the products. N2O5, it will give exclusively NO3. So number of oxides of nitrogen which produce HNO3. So NO2 can produce, N2O4 can produce, N2O5 also can produce. So NO2, N2O4, they can give HNO3, apart from that HNO2 also, but we required HNO3. So these three oxides can give nitric acid on hydrolysis. Total number of moles of phosphorus hydrogen bonds in products when 1 mole of white phosphorus completely reacts with the potassium hydroxide solution. Whether it is a potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, the products are same only. White phosphorus complete reaction means we have to take 3 moles of potassium hydroxide, 3 moles of water, which will give the phosphine, plus we'll get 3 moles of potassium hypophosphite. This is a complete reaction. Here total phosphine anyhow it has 3 pH bonds, and in KH2PO2, H2PO2 structure is like this. O minus and this is K plus, and this one molecule it has 2 again phosphorus hydrogen bonds, but we have 3 moles, and 2 into 3, this is 6, and here 3, total we have 9 pH bonds. Because they are asking total number of moles of pH bonds when 1 mole of P4. So you will get 9 moles of pH bonds, you will get it. Here 3, here 6. Now the last question in this session. PCl5 exists in solid state as PCl4 plus PCl6 minus. Sum of number of types of phosphorus fluorine bonds in PCl4 plus and PCl6 minus. And PCl4 plus, you can see the structure of PCl4 is, it is a perfect tetrahedral in geometry. Here all phosphorus fluorine bonds are identical in nature, so we have only one type of phosphorus fluorine bond here. In case of PCl6 minus, again here phosphorus can undergo perfect octahedral geometry. In all these 6 phosphorus fluorine bonds are identical in nature. Again they have only one type of phosphorus fluorine bond here. So total sum of number of types of phosphorus chlorine. Here one type and here one type. Total we have two types of phosphorus chlorine bonds in PCl5 solid state. So that's it. So these are the few important questions related to the 15th groups. So if you check these questions, you can cover maximum 15th group for various type of competitive examinations. Thank you.